podcast. This channel is really about me documenting my journey into the tech field, but I see a lot of YouTubers are putting out videos, car review videos on their tech channel. So why don't I do the same thing with this vehicle? So this is my actual car. We have this car for 5 months. I won't give you too much stats about it. I'm not gonna get too techie. Basically, I just talk about the car and also the pros and cons about it. And I'll tell you, is it worth the money after 5 months, basically? Is it worth you getting this car? And again, I've had this car for about 5 months. And I'll just let you know if it's a yes or a no, should you get it or should you not get it? But without further ado, let's start talking about this car and go from there. All right, so let's talk about the exterior since we're outside. So I like how the front looks. I'm a big fan of the headlights. Just the way it's designed is really cool. BMW tried to do something like this, but to me they failed. It looks really weird on their newest models, the 7 Series. I think the XM looks kind of weird, but I don't know, it just kind of looks strange. But for this car, it looks really good. So I love the V grille design. I'm not crazy about chrome. I wish they kind of blacked that out, but it's still an awesome car. Here's your new Nissan logo, obviously, right? You have your camera here for your front-facing camera. You have 2 sensors on each side for your parking sensors. The car does not come with fog lights, as you can see. But I do think the fog lights are integrated into the headlight unit. So, yeah, this is your daytime running lights, this part here. And obviously, you know everything else here is your signal and all that, so your high beams. So yeah, that's the front of the car. Love how it looks. Really look cool, man. I love how it kind of has like a sleek look for a big car, for a car this massive. I kind of like that a lot. And here's your side profile, 20-inch wheels. You have your turn signal here integrated into the side mirror. If you can see that, boom. And there's your another chrome trim here. I'm not crazy about this trim. I think trim is kind of outdated, but I love how they put the Pathfinder name into the trim, this trim part or bar, whatever you want to call it. But I wish they kind of blacked this one out. I'm not sure. I'm not crazy about chrome anymore. But it still looks awesome on this car. I will give that to them. Looks beautiful. All right, let's go around here some more to the side. I've seen some models where the top. I'm sorry for the noise. There's a lot of cars passing by. There's this giant truck, so loud. But I've seen models of this car where they blacked out the entire top. It looks really cool, but this doesn't have it. I think this color is called Baja or Baja Brown, something like that. Or Baja Platinum, something like that. Hope I said that right. It looks kind of brown, but it's supposed to be silver. It's weird. It looks awesome on this car, though. I'll give that to them. And here's the back of the car, obviously. I did block out our plate number because that's none of your business. And you have the Pathfinder name here, named across the rear end of the car. And here's what I mean about the boxy shape look. It has like a boxy shape look, right? But the front has like this sleek look. I really like that. They made that work so well. And I'm just loving how like this part here, there's like a, see that? There's like a boxy shape right here. And the headlight unit is added to that. It just looks really good. I love that so much. And here's your platinum trim logo, four-wheel drive. I wish they took this wiper and tucked it inside. I would like that very much. You have your mirror here. I'm sorry, your mirror. You have your camera, your back-facing camera. Okay. Yeah, man. So far, nice back. You have your towing connections here for your capability, your towing capability, excuse me. Right? You can attach to here. There's a bar in the very bottom. There you go. Oh, drop something. All right, let's go around the back some more. And pretty much the same here as the other side. So let's talk about the interior now. So let me go on the driver's side and show you that. The interior of this vehicle. Now, let me just put this on the ground real quick. All right. So this is a your keyless entry, obviously. Your key fob is inside this bag or your pocket. To lock the door, you just kind of do one of those. To open it, just grab the handle and it opens. And here's the interior of the car. Here's your door. Have your different connections, not connections, but your controls. all the windows are automatic, so if you just push down, they all could just roll down at this, not the same time, but they roll down automatically. So you could just kind of press all the way down and the window goes all the way down by itself. You don't have to kind of press and hold it. And all the all four windows does it, which is really cool. You have your set here for your chair, the steering wheel. That makes any sense? I think you know what this is. I'm not sure what the name is properly, but you know what this is. What else? You have your soft touch here. This is leather. I'm not crazy about cowskin. I wish Nissan had an option, which is like synthetic leather, like made out of mushrooms or something like that. I'm not crazy about cowskin, but this is still nice. Yeah, here's your interior. Hop inside here. And there you go. So this, the gauge unit is a monitor, a LCD monitor. Let me stop and just, there you go. Let me just turn this on real quick. There you go. Close the door. Less noise. There you go. So this is your monitor gauge system. You do have your head-up display, if you can see that. I'm not sure if you see that zero. Maybe if I can do something else here. Let me just mess with it a little bit more. There it is. See that? On the window, that's your head-up display unit. This car does come with a 9-speaker audio system made by Bose. You see that right there? There's a name, Bose. Boom. I think the speakers, there's one speaker here. There's another one in the front and so on, so on. Yeah, here's your 12.3 infotainment system. Obviously, it's touchscreen. You have Apple wireless, but Android, it is USB connection only, which is a major, I hate that so much. They have to change that real nice. I mean, real, real soon. I really don't like that. But here it is. Here's your typical control system, your volume, your change your song control here. This is where you control the... your monitor here, your gauge monitor, if that's what you say. It has your advanced cruise control. I won't get too techie with that again. And I love how they still use buttons on Nissan. Everything is not all inside the screen. I'm not crazy about that. I still like buttons. I'm glad they kept that like that. So if I want to press something and just get right to the point, you know, menu is right there. Boom. Go right to menu, audio. Boom, audio, and choose your different options, AM and FM, Sirius XM, Bluetooth audio, and all that stuff. Yeah, keep the buttons alive. Don't kill off the buttons, please. I love how the AC vent is still manual. You can just control it. Some cars, it's the opposite. You have to go inside the infotainment system and control it. The air direction is crazy. It's just way too much. Yeah, here's your AC, your climate control. You have your dual climate control here. This car does have both ventilated and heated seats. And here's your you can warm up your steering wheel here. You can control the back passenger's climate control with these two buttons. Really awesome. And here's your shifter. I think this is a 9-speed, right? Really cool. And you have your USB A to your right and USB C to your left. You have more outlet stuff here to charge something. I'm not sure. This is this right here. I just touched. That's your wireless charging pad. You put your just shove your phone in there and it charges your phone wirelessly. And you have other control systems here. You have your drive modes, of course, sport, snow, all that stuff, towing mode. So that's cool. I love how they put the Pathfinder name here. And this is your box here. As you can see, you have a lot of stuff in there. Some glasses, sunglasses, and all that stuff is in here. And let's go in the back and see what's going on back there. All right. So, here's the back seat. It's a bench, right? You do have a third row in the back as well, which is cool. And you have your climate control here for your passengers in the back. They can control the AC back here. You do have USB C and A and some other stuff here to charge or plug in whatever device. Oh, excuse me, my God. Excuse me. All right, here we go. Oh, I'm so unprofessional. You do have your panoramic sunroof. See that? Not sure you can see all of that. Get some nice lighting up in here. Let me close the door. Too much noise. Boom. Yeah, so here's your second row. Yep, everything's pretty luxury and up in here. Black leather. Nice car. Very spacious, as you can see. I'm 6 foot tall and got a lot of room here. A lot of room. Nice room for my head. Yeah, a lot of roomy. A lot of roomy. A lot of room. Again, the third row seat. Let me show you how to recline. Not recline, but how to fold the seat. The this back seat here. So there's a button you push here. And the seat just starts to go forward. Look at that. And that's how you'll access the third row seat. Right? Pretty cool. And this does also fold this part here. If you do this, there you go. Okay. The back passengers on the third row seat, for them to leave the car, they will have to push this button for the seat to also go back or go forward like I just did. Let me just fold this back up with one hand, which is kind of impossible. Oh, I think I got it. Oh my God, that was a lot of work. All right, so yeah, let me show you the back tailgate. There you go. So that's what it does with just one button push. To fold the third row seat, there's some levers here. Well, first you have to kind of put these down, the headrests. And push this up and it just folds. Boom. There you go. And now you have some more room in the back. Pretty cool. There's your buttons right here to both lock it and to close it. We'll just lock it real quick. And it goes down. What else? Yeah. There's your 2023 Nissan Pathfinder Platinum Edition. There's somebody walking by. Good morning. Yeah, man, so we enjoy this car a lot. Let me just turn the camera back to me. Get some lighting. Yeah, so we're a fan of this car a lot. It's definitely a go for us. We had it for about 5 months. It's good on gas. We traveled to Orlando with it. Some highway miles, obviously. Yeah, it's really cool car. It's very spacious. It seats about 8 people in here. 8 adults. Got your... You can throw some stuff in the very top here, right? I'm not sure what you're gonna do with that, but that's also available. Yeah, man. So like I said, a lot of YouTubers are doing car reviews, so I just figured I'd do the same thing since I have a tech channel, and I'll just talk about this really cool car. It's pretty teched out, and it's a really cool car. It's luxury. It's fun to drive. It's just a big spacious SUV. We like it a lot. So there you have it. That's the 2023 Nissan Pathfinder Platinum. Hope you enjoyed this video and hope you got some value from it. Nissan, if you want to invite me to do some more car reviews on your newest models, feel free to contact me through this channel or other car brands. Let me know. I'm down. This is fun to do. And yeah, thanks for watching. Peace out. Yeah, thanks. Peace.